The A321neo and its longer-range derivatives have taken the world by storm. Given Boeing's struggle to catch up and get the 737 MAX 10 into service in a timely manner, many airlines have been lining up for Airbus's longest narrow-body aircraft. As you may already know, the A321neo is the longest variant of the A320neo family. One step down is the extremely popular A320neo, and then at the short end is the rather unpopular A319neo. On the surface, the A321neo has just a few versions: the basic A321neo, the longer-range A321LR, and the extra-long-range A321XLR. Their marketing names essentially tell us that range is the key difference. But what does this look like on a technical level? Are there more variations with the A321neo? Let's take an in-depth look for today's video. If range is a key difference, Airbus's official website is just a little confusing when displaying such differences. For the A321neo, the table here displays a range of 7,400 kilometers, making the conversions this figure is just shy of 4,000 nautical miles, 3,995 nautical miles to be precise. But then, scrolling down, the range of the A321LR is shown as essentially being identical, 4,000 nautical miles. Of course, if you want to get technical, it's 5 nautical miles more, which obviously wouldn't justify having the long-range name attached to it. But then, finally, the A321XLR is marketed with a range of up to 4,700 nautical miles, which is indeed a notable difference. So, at least on the marketing side, the A321neo and A321LR would appear to be identical. What's going on here? Well, to solve this mystery, and much more, it's a lot better to look at the technical documentation, which opens up a detailed world of variations. If we dive into the European Union Aviation Safety Agency, or EASA's, type certificate datasheet for the A321, we can see that the A321neo can be divided into not just 3 variants, but 11. The precise model numbers will be either 251, 252, 253, 271, or 272. Following these numbers will be either an N, NX, or NY. Let's go over what all of these mean. Well, A321neos with a 5 in their model number are powered by variations of CFM LEAP 1A engines. For example, A321 251, 252, and 253. Of course, these numbers will either be followed by an N, NX, or NY. Meanwhile, aircraft models with a 7 are powered by the Pratt & Whitney PW1100 geared turbofan family of engines, including the A321 271 and 272, again ending with N or NX. Whether it's 251 versus 252 or 271 versus 272 depends on the specific engine model. And so what about the N, NX, and NY suffixes? Well, N is the base designation, indicating that it's a NEO, or New Engine Option, aircraft. This fuselage has 4 doors on each side, more or less evenly spaced from front to back. With this door configuration, the jet can only carry a maximum of 220 passengers. If there's an X next to it, then it's an A321neo equipped with Airbus Cabin Flex, or ACF, configuration. This sees a different door and emergency exit configuration than the earlier N model. As you can see here, there are 3 large doors, one at the front, one at the back, and one rear of the wing. The notable update is the elimination of the full door forward of the wing and the appearance of a smaller pair of doors over the wing. As explained by a Cora contributor, this different door/window exit allows operators to increase the aircraft's overall capacity, as high as 244 passengers, according to EASA documentation. Legacy carriers who are likely to carry fewer passengers than budget airlines can deactivate door 3, rear of the wing. Budget airlines wishing to carry more passengers will need to activate that door in order to comply with emergency and evacuation regulations. Leeham News notes that the elimination of the set of doors forward of the wing not only brings weight advantages, but also gives airlines more flexibility on where to stop any premium cabin and start the next cabin segment. Airbus Cabin Flex, or ACF, has been the newest standard for A321neo fuselages since around 2018, meaning that you won't find A321neos with this door layout rolling off the assembly line anymore. Finally, the NY suffix is used to denote the brand new extra-long-range A321XLR, which we'll explain in more detail later on. So, we know that the A321neo family varies by engine type and door configuration. But what are the differences that allow those variations in range? Well, it's quite interesting that you won't find the term A321LR anywhere in the EASA type certificate datasheet. Actually, you won't find A321neo anywhere within the 200-page document either. The N suffix is simply used instead. As a contributor on Stack Exchange explains, the A321neo is the base model fitted with three fuel tanks, two wing tanks, and a center tank. From there, customers can add more fuel tanks for more range at the expense of cargo space, going from the base three tanks up to four or even five. And so, the option with three ACTs, or additional center tanks, is the one marketed as the A321LR. To bring things full circle, this would somewhat explain why Airbus's website shows the A321neo maximum range as identical to the A321LR. It's ultimately left to the customer to decide just how many additional center fuel tanks they want in their neos. While it would be nicer if this could be made clearer to the public, we understand that the average aviation enthusiast is not the target market for Airbus's promotional material. And how do things differ on the A321XLR, otherwise known as the A321-253NY? Well, Airbus explains that structurally, the key addition is the rear center tank for extra range. This tank has a capacity of 12,900 litres of fuel. It's not just another tank, however. Airbus had designed this new rear center tank to be integrated within the fuselage, in the underbelly of the aircraft. Aviation regulators took issue with this and warned Airbus that the risk of fire had to be mitigated to allow for a safe evacuation of passengers and crew in an accident. Michael Singer, head of the Large Aeroplanes Department at EASA, stated, "We needed to be sure that the design location of the tank would not in itself trigger a safety issue, that the tank was adequately robust and crash-resistant, even in a case where the landing gear failed or an unknown threat such as an item on the runway could damage the tank. And finally, we wanted proof that if the tank was compromised, the leakage rate would be limited so as not to pose a threat." Airbus responded by making the tank more crash-resistant, introducing stronger material compositions and additional supporting structural provisions to protect the fuselage. To make full use of this new fuel capacity, the A321XLR's maximum takeoff weight is increased over the A321LR, 101 tonnes compared to 97 tonnes. To handle the increased weight, Airbus reinforced the main and nose landing gear. It also increased the A321XLR's water-carrying capacity to cater to those longer flights. In late September, Air Astana announced it had installed additional fuel tanks on at least one of its A321LR aircraft. The goal was to provide enough fuel to operate non-stop from Kazakhstan to London while circumventing the airspace of certain countries. There weren't many technical details released, but if Air Astana's A321LR has another fuel tank, it would essentially make it an A321XLR, would it not? At any rate, it's quite an interesting development that we thought was worth mentioning. But ultimately, when it comes to A321neo variants, yes, a lot of it has to do with fuel capacity at the expense of cargo space in the aircraft's belly. However, as we've learned in today's video, there are also variations in emergency exit doors and engine options. And so, how much of this information did you already know about the A321neo? Was there anything new for you? Let us know by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.